Finn, welcome to Swansea City. Really good to have you here. A bit of a dramatic deadline day for yourself, but you must be excited to get down to work now everything is sorted out.
Yeah, no, really delighted to be here. I mean, it was a crazy one yesterday, getting a call about 4:30 and then leaving London about 10:30. So it was a late one, right on the dot, but no, I'm really happy to be there. And it's been a great first day with the boys today.
Yeah, no, yeah, I don't think you've had much sleep if you were up early to come to training again this morning, but I guess that just shows just how hungry you were to get here and to get the move done.
Yeah, exactly. I just wanted to get in, get started. I was up at 6:30 this morning getting in, getting all the medical done, but now it's done. No, that's the hard bit done, and now just focus on working.
Yeah, and I'm sure, Finn, there'd be interest in you from a number of championship clubs. What was it about Swansea that made you feel like this is the right place for you to come at this point in your career?
Definitely the way they play. They like to play football, play out from the back. And for me personally, I'm not a massive player. I'm not really physical. So, and my game is to kind of play football on the floor, balls in behind, and play that way. And I think Swansea was a great fit for that.
Yeah, and I guess talking to Russell Martin, the head coach, you would have just underlined that, wouldn't you? Just the desire to players have the ball at their feet and play. And I guess, you know, that's what you want to be a part of. That's what you want to experience as a player. You want to play with the ball at your feet.
Yeah, exactly. And when I spoke to Russell on the phone, that's exactly what he said to me. We like to play out from the back. We're a ball-playing side. Have most of the possession every week, 70% and more. And he said he thinks what I could bring to the side is that last bit in the final third, being clinical, get that last cross in, that last ball. And I think I can show that and prove that.
Yeah, because you're a defender, Finn, but you play with an awful lot of energy. You know, you can get up and down the flank. But like, how would you describe yourself as a player in your own words?
Very energetic, very intense. I like to get out to people, put tackles in. I've got a nice cross. I like to see myself as being good in the final third, getting that final cross in, that final ball. So I think I'll be able to provide that for the team.
Yeah, and you're a Wales under 21 international, so you come into a dressing room where there's a few familiar faces for you, aren't there?
Yeah. I mean, Dan Williams is here. Obviously, he's gone on loan, so I didn't get to meet him. But Brandon Cooper and Webby, both know them, top lads. So it's nice to have a few people to know before you come in. Just helps you settle in a bit better, yeah.
Yeah, how much does it help to walk into a room and to know some of the people in there and not for it to be a completely certain
issue? It's much better, yeah. Have a little chat, they kind of tell you this and that, a few little bits, give you a few guides. So yeah, it's much nicer and easier.
Yeah, and just to go through your career up to this point, Finn, you were in Arsenal's academy from a very young age, I think 6 or 7 years
ago.
Yeah,
very young, yeah.
You know, were there for a number of years. Yeah. You know, what was that like as an experience, and how did that come about?
I was just training in Brighton, where I'm from, just doing some individual training. Got a 6-week trial up there, signed. So I was there from the age of 6 to 16, and then obviously I got let go. But yeah, my time there was unbelievable. Some great experiences, some great coaches, and got everything I needed, and it's made me the player I am today.
Yeah, I mean, what coaches would you have worked with there, and what players were sort of in that age bracket as you were coming through?
Yeah, I mean, a few, Greg Lincoln and Ryan Gary, I think they were two big ones. And then there was some top players in there, like Yunus, Musa, Miguel Aziz, so a few top players in there. But yeah, then when I got released, they obviously went to Worthing, and I think for me that is it's the biggest part of my career, and that's what's put me where I am now.
Yeah, because I was going to ask you about that, because obviously, you know, a difficult thing for any young player to go through, and a brave thing to drop into non-league and play, but you've obviously made the most of it. I mean, how much did you learn, not just in terms of football, but I guess about yourself as a person, having to overcome that bit of adversity?
Yeah, everything. Yeah, you kind of to do that and then bounce back, showed massive perseverance from me and determination. And to get myself in the starting men's team at the age of 16, and to get that experience with men every week has made me who I am today, and it's made me progress in the way I have. So no, that's the most important part of my development.
Yeah, do you think it benefited you to step up and be playing senior football while still a teenager? Do you just think it's accelerated your development?
Yeah, completely. Yeah, it's massive. Yeah, I'm already coming into Brentford with a bit of experience in men's football, so for them, that's massive, you know what I mean? I've already got the experience of dealing with men and marking them and the physicality, so no, it's brilliant.
And how did the opportunity to go to Brentford come about from there?
Yeah, so no, I was playing week in, week out for about 22 games. Had a few calls and that, and a few agents here and there. And then one of them said to me, the agent I have now, Brentford want to sign you on a 3-year deal. No-brainer, completely. So went and had a look about, training ground, flats, this, that, and then, yeah, just got the deal done.
Yeah, because you started off with the B team, but I mean, I think you progressed very quickly to training with the first team, didn't you? And that was just fantastic.
Yeah, I signed with the B team, and then I think within maybe a month or two max, I was training first team regularly. And then beginning of this season, I got promoted to the first team. So no, it's been a great time there.
And obviously, you look. We won't talk about it too much, but you were on the bench for the playoff final against Swansea a couple of years ago, and you've made your Premier League debut within the last year against Southampton. You know, I mean, just fantastic experiences. It must just whet your appetite for more.
Yeah, it's everything you dream of as a kid. But when you get that, then it makes you want more. You know what I mean? So that's why coming here gives me that opportunity, and I think I'm ready, and I can show what I can do when I get the opportunity here. So that's the whole point of me coming in and getting that chance.
Yeah, and I guess it's an opportunity you want to make the most of, isn't it? Because it's that chance for regular game time and the exposure to hopefully week in, week out.
Yeah, of course. That's the main goal, get in and stay in. That's the main goal for me, and show Russell what I can do and stay in that team.
What do you hope that you can achieve individually over the course of this season, Finn, and what do you hope you can help the team as a whole?
I think help the team get some crosses in, and I want to get assists and goals. Obviously, help them defensively, that's my main job. But like Russ said to me, maybe struggling in the final third a bit, so if I can put that deadly ball in or that cross, I'd like to help them there as much as I can.
Well, we certainly hope you do, Finn, and welcome again to Swansea City.
Thank you very much.